He was an upstate native and World War I hero who didn't get the recognition he deserved until decades later.
Tonight, a special honor for Corporal Freddie Stowers. WYFF News 4's Mandy Gaither has more from Anderson.
Nearly 100 years since his death, Corporal Freddie Stowers lives on at Anderson University.
We've watched a long time that separate honors have been given to Corporal Freddie Stowers. However, Great Uncle Freddie Stowers stands for something far more great, I guess, than we can ever put into words.
In World War I, without regard for his own safety, Stowers led his squad to an enemy machine gun nest which had killed many fellow soldiers. It was destroyed. Still, Stowers pressed on, attacking a second trench line. Despite being gravely wounded by gunfire, he urged his men to continue on. It wasn't until 1991 that President George H.W. Bush posthumously awarded Stowers the nation's highest military honor. It was the first time an African American from South Carolina was given that honor.
They said it may have been an oversight. Did I think so? No. I don't think it was an oversight, but I am glad that somebody knew and took the time out to bring this to pass, not only for his family, but just for the world to know.
The Sandy Springs native, forever held in the hearts of many, now with a tangible place to be remembered.
The statue was given to Anderson University by the family of the late John Rainey.
Rainey wanted to honor the memory of great South Carolinians and beautify the AU campus.